Welcome to Politics and Dirtbags with Bill Vanderzam, brought to you by Way to Grow, the best dirtbags in the business.
Welcome to the show, Politics and Dirtbags. I'm Bill Vanderzam, and this is my rebel nephew, Marty Vanderzam. Today we're going to talk a little bit about what's happening to the economy and the world, with wages going where they are in certain sectors, and what the impact and the effect of that. And I'll start by suggesting, Marty, that we've got a problem in government and with corporations generally, government corporations. They're paying their CEOs, their vice presidents, and they've got a long list of them, enormous salaries. And you know what that'll do? That'll only spill over into the rest of the economy, and you'll see strikes and disputes, and everybody wanted the same thing, and I don't blame them. When you've got 45% of the people in BC Hydro, 45% plus in BC Hydro, making six-figure salaries, like $100,000, $200,000 a year, that's just going to rub off and start something happening elsewhere, and so it should. So it's got to be looked at a lot differently. I'm for unions. I have no problem with unions. But government unions, I've got a bit of a problem because I think they don't have any competition. They simply make demands. It's not like they're having to compete with some other government. Whereas in the private sector, you make demands of a company and they've got to consider then, what will that do to the company? Will the company still compete against the other company? So government unions, government employees, government wages are a problem because it sets an unrealistic stage. Have you any comment on that?
Yes, I do, Uncle.
Oh,
I
knew
have
you
a
would.
Comment.
I knew
okay,
you would.
Now listen to this one. Okay, now I agree. I agree with that in BC Hydro, I mean, it is wacko how much money those guys are making.
BC Hydro, it's BC Lotto, it's ICBC, it's all of those, and it's government employees generally.
Fair enough. But that argument with those guys on top, now the argument, this is where I say, if I was to hire a guy and I was to say, I'm going to give you $200,000, but I'm going to need it all. I'm going to need everything you got. Well, I tell you, at $200,000 a year, you're going to get it all, right? Now, the theory is, right, the corporate theory is, pay them $400,000 and you're going to get double all. Pay them a million and you're going to get five times all. Well, that makes no damn sense, because you hire the guy for $200,000 and you say, hey, you're going to work 20 hours a day. He's going to work 20 hours a day. Double his wages, he's still only going to work $20 a day. You can't get more, you know, you can't get more from a wrung out dish rag. It is wrung out, and you should, for $200,000, be able to wring that sucker out like an old dish rag, get every ounce that he can produce.
Well,
right?
Yeah, it's
right? So that's the way, but those in the top there, it's just ridiculous. I mean, you've got guys making $500,000 that should only be making $100,000, you know what I mean? But you get, it spills down right away, that those guys' excesses, you say, oh, it spills down to all the
other demands elsewhere,
okay,
and
rightly
so.
I can understand why they would. Fair enough.
If some guy controlling smart meters is being paid $250,000 to control smart meters, I don't know what's so difficult about that. Or if you're in charge of the BC Ferry Corporation and you get $1 million for controlling the ferries, there's not a whole lot to that. Hey, you know what? The guy that's working for you in the soil business, he's going to say, hey, Marty, I'm not happy with what you're paying me per hour. Look what they're paying in government. He may not get it himself, but he compares, and rightly so.
If we had real fair trade, which is another show on another date, I can argue that point. But I was at the dentist's office a while ago reading a McLean's magazine, and they're going off about how in Canada, how many teachers make six-figure salaries, how many firemen. And it said the police department in Abbotsford, of 100, let me wrong, yeah. I think it was 105 officers, 96 made over $100,000 a year, right? Okay, fair enough. And then they right away compare it to a town in the States where the average cop makes like, 57,000 or some damn thing. So I'm thinking, oh, well, fair enough. But why do we always have to let the influence of Walmart You know what I mean? Like, there's Walmart, America, the land of Walmart and traders, right? Why do we always have to use the lower end to be our influence to come down? Now, when I was a young guy working in business, we were never a union firm, and yet when I've been in the union, PPWC, and I learned lots about unions, and I'm a pro-union guy. Right? But in our own business, we were never a union, never had, never asked to be. But the economy used to follow the union. When the unions went up here, we had to be here. You couldn't be down here and the unions up there, it's pick up a gun, you know what I'm saying? You always had that influence. So as the unions kept bringing standards up, we had no choice but to compete. And it brought us to where we are today. Now, but what happens now? We let Walmart in here, and ever since Walmart came here, my wife used to work at Safeway back in the 70s. Safeway. She was, good paying jobs. That whole industry now, all the union got bought out, and now, hell, they're all making minimum wage. And part-time, everybody's part-damn time. So now, in the old days, the union was the influence. We followed uphill. When General Motors came into a town in eastern Canada, prosperity followed. Now, we follow Walmart down. When Walmart comes into a town, there is no prosperity. I walk into Merritt the other day, they let a Walmart in there, and I'm kind of going, boy, nothing got better in Merritt. I see boarded up shops all over the place, right? Now, when I see a fireman and police, teachers making $100,000, good for them. That's a good reason to make everybody else in Walmart say, hey, time for us to get a share. When the largest corporation on the planet doing billions and billions of dollars has to pay minimum wage, something's wrong. Something's wrong. So I say, don't start beating up these poor firemen because they're making decent, good money. You know, that's a good influence to have, be following decent, good money. But when you have this ridiculous pigs at the trough in BC Hydro and Mobil, I heard they got the president of Mobil made $500 million in 1 year. Oh, that is...
That's crazy.
That's crazy, right? That's my slant on that issue.
Thank you for watching. Please send us your comments and questions. That's what makes the show.
You have a choice. Way to grow or a competitor. Somebody that doesn't care or somebody like Way to Grow. 30 years, sleepless nights, trying to guarantee what goes in that bag is the best performing product possible. Always ask for Way to Grow products at only the best retailers in Western Canada.